That could be a scare card for Vanessa. If Elky raised preflop with an ace in his hand.
Vanessa bets 12,000.
This is a defensive bet. She'd rather fire than have to check call a big bet from Elky.
Elky mucks. So as Russo wins a relatively small pot, we look back at the two pivotal hands that keyed her victory over Daniel Negreanu in the quarterfinals.
I had Jack 7 off suit. The flop came Jack, Jack 4. Then I minimum raise him to 25,000. And I knew at that point that I would be able to get Daniel to think I didn't have the Jack. So fortunately for me, the 4 on the turn means I've got the boat. And then I push in, all in.
Why do I feel like I'm getting bluffed by another woman?
And he thinks, and he makes the call. I ended up doubling up, so at that point, we're back to even in chips. I finally pick up pocket deuces, monster hand that it is. I flop 3 of a kind of set. The turn came and paired the board, so I had deuces full of 3s. I check pushed there too, knowing that it would be hard for Daniel to put me on such a strong hand. If I just tried to slow play it and then bet the river, it would be too obvious.
28.
All in.
All right, I call.
So I went for it, and luckily it worked. And I guess I'm hoping to get that zone back for my match against Elky.
She's in more than the zone. She's been playing on a different plane.
And in the process, she's been making yours truly look pretty stupid. I think I've picked against her more than once or twice. She's burned me every time.
Yep, you said it. Our GoDaddy.com pocket cam shows us ace tray suited for Vanessa.
Did I pick against her here too? I did, didn't I?
Oh yeah, you did.
Oh no.
9-8 for Elky. Inside straight draw for Elky, he checks.
Top pair for Vanessa.
She bets 3,000.
Half the pot.
Elky calls.
He's gonna hope to hit the gin card, a 7.
4 of diamonds on the turn.
Check.
Check, check. Elky hits his straight.
There's the argument in favor of Vanessa having bet her hand on the turn instead of letting Elky see a free card. And now he's slow playing it. He's checking it over to her, hoping she'll do exactly what she just did, Craig. Bet 13,000.
He raises to 45,500.
Oh, that hurts if you're Vanessa Russo. You don't want to get bluffed. But ace 3 doesn't really feel that strong after your opponent pulls this move on you.
45,500.
The trouble too, Craig, is that it's Elky, a guy who we know can pull off a bluff in this spot.
She calls. A costly miscalculation, and Elky takes the pot.
Nice river. I slow played my way into that. Nice in.
Elky getting some timely assistance from a 7 there, but in the quarterfinals against Phil Hellmuth, he didn't need any help.
I looked at 2 queens. When I raced and he re-raced. I mean, I didn't even bother studying him.
He was with aces and he moved on almost right away and he was like, obviously an easy call.
All in.
I call.
All in.
I figured that he'd make some mistakes against me. He'd try to bluff off his money, and I figured I'd read him well.
So I won the game very quickly.
I mean, you know, you deal aces versus queens heads up. Well, that's tough.
Actually, he was quite all right. He didn't whine as much as I expected him to, so.
Ooh, that's a tough comment. Didn't whine as much as I expected to. Well, didn't he get the memo? Phil's changed.
Even across the pond, Hellmuth has a reputation.
7-4 for Elky. He raises to 7,000. Ace deuce for Vanessa. She calls. Elky hits his 7, now with 2 pair.
These paired boards, often tempting for players to try to steal.
After 8, Vanessa checks, Elky bets 8,500, and Vanessa calls.
She knows he'll make that bet with or without a hand, so she'll tear one off with ace high.
9 of spades on the turn, Vanessa checks. Elky bets 15,500.
A lot of players won't make this bet, so credit Elky with the courage to fire another barrel. He's not giving Vanessa credit for a better hand like a king
Vanessa raises to 31,000, and Elkie calls.
I like where Vanessa's head's at, but Elkie's so stubborn, he's not letting his hand go here.
Six of clubs on the river.
Check.
Vanessa checks.
Ace.
As does Elkie. Elkie's two pair takes it down.
Vanessa may have been able to take that pot down with a big enough bet on the river, but it's so much easier said than done.
Elkie liking the looks of the number seven so far in the semifinals. Back with more from the National Heads Up Poker Championship. As we welcome you back, a look inside a Caesar's Palace suite, something Sam Farha would no doubt enjoy, but not as much as he enjoyed the key hand in his quarterfinal win over David Williams.
I had queen 10 of clubs. Flop comes queen, queen 6.
Queens full for Williams, and he's gonna get action because Sammy Flop tripped queens.
Uh-oh.
The river, the 10 hit, gives me full house.
Wowzers.
He bets 15,000. Williams raises to 35,000.
This could get nuclear. The nuts versus the second nuts.
Sammy raises.
I guess I'm all in.
You're all in?
Yeah.
Sammy calls and shows him the unbeatable hand. David's eliminated.
That is brutal.
Wow.
I mean, he didn't do nothing wrong. I would have been in his shoes. I would have played the same way. I was fortunate to catch the 10. I was lucky at the end.
Well, at least we know that Sammy's not too proud to admit when he sucks out and gets lucky. Every player's done it, and he was on the good end of it that time.
Ace-queen suited for Huck. He raises to 8,000. Farha suited in diamonds as well with king-deuce. He calls. Sammy has top pair. He checks. Seed has middle pair and a Broadway draw. He checks as well. Trey on the turn. Sammy bets 10,000. Huck calls. Trip queens for seed.
10 queen or an ace would have done it.
Sammy bets 10,000 again.
Now Huck's trying to figure out how much he can get out of Sammy.
He raises to 35,000. Sammy calls.
That looked pretty automatic.
Either way, buddy.
Didn't feel like Sammy thought about that one enough.
Good on.
Trip queens, winning it for Huck right there. And in the quarterfinals, his decisive cards came in a group of three as well.
I had pocket eights on the button. I made it 6,000. Dave re-raised me 13,000 more. I had a slight chip lead on him, so I made a giant re-raise. I put him all in for like 150.
I'm all in.
I call.
And he pretty quickly called me with ace-queen. You know, he made an amazing call.
You have a big hand?
Yeah, you're never happy if you get all your money with eights before the flop. Usually you're crushed with those blinds. So it was basically a coin flip, you know, for the whole match, and I won the coin flip.
Craig, much in the same way that Farha was willing to admit that he got a little lucky in his match, Huck not too proud to say it was a coin flip, you know, just basically a toss-up.
King queen for seed. He's up almost 2-1 in chips. Blinds now 2 and 4,000. Huck raises to 10,000. Sammy with 5 deuce suited. He'll call.
Sammy all too happy to gamble with a wide variety of hands. 5 deuce suited. He's in the mix.
4, 10, 8 on the flop.
Not quite as much in the mix anymore, looking at that flop.
After check, check, ace on the turn gives both players a straight draw.
Nothing worth betting, apparently.
Board pairs on the river. King high, the best hand.
Not just any king high, Craig. The best king high. King queen.
Sammy bets 15,000. And Huck folds.
A little surprised to see Huck fold without any thought whatsoever to making a call. Sammy checked it twice.
Blinds 2 and 4,000 over table 4. Elkie up by over 150,000 in chips. He looks at 9-7.